Had a nice 2 weeks here. Little marina right here to check in. Check-in process was awesome. To you cruisers that are doing this route, come to here to check in. Skip Boqueron, skip Mayagüez up to the north. Come here, check in. Muy fácil, fantastic time, no big deal. Spent 2 weeks here working on some projects and stuff. I got my air conditioning ripped out so I can redo the batteries. And visited a canvas shop to get some material to make dinghy chaps. So we'll be visiting that shortly. And yeah, 2 weeks too long. That's been my motto. Haven't been able to adhere to that, obviously, because I've been in Luperon for the last 3 months. But 2 weeks feels about the right time to be in one location. So I am headed to Boqueron tonight. Do a little fiesta-ing there. The adventure continues. We are headed to east along the south coast of Puerto Rico. All kinds of rad stuff in store. Here we go. Because of that. Woo-wee! It's party time. Actually, I should be getting to my anchorage here in Boqueron before that hits. But it's always a really good idea to take your canvas down. It's gonna rain like crazy there. So I put the sail cover on. I don't want getting the sail all wet. Booted on the old iron Jenny. And we're almost there. So we should drop the hook and then that will fall right on top of us. You can see the center of that right there, kind of spreading off to the south, which means it's headed our way. This one got dark real quick and yeah, that's gonna drop right on top of us. Probably another 10 minutes here. How close are we to anchor? We are approximately 1 mile. We're going 6. We're gonna get there in 10 minutes. This is gonna be close. Let's see how accurate we are here. 10 minutes later. Woo, that thing is right on us. Right on us. See if I can get my rain catcher out before it starts raining. 16 feet of water. Find a little anchorage spot. Right over here, I reckon. Let's get in. Got the rain catcher up. This is gonna hit any second. right on the other side of that building. So let me show you my rain catcher real quick. Basically some triangles sewed together, get as much surface area as I can. I just tie it with a rolling hitch. So that catches it there. It's tied down here, reinforced with a through-hole fitting on that. So if you look at it, okay, from here, water all collects right into there, into the hose. And I like to compare storms. I could just run a hose to the tank, but I like to see how much of a storm, how much I can collect. This thing looks like it's a good 5-6 galloner. I love collecting rain. I think it's super cool. I think it kind of goes hand in hand with the whole concept of sailing, using nature, using the elements and everything to help you survive. So obviously we've got the solar for the power, we've got wind for traveling, and we've got a rain collector for catching water. I've got two different filter systems that the water goes through prior to drinking. I haven't had any ill effects so far. I've been collecting rain for around 6-7 months now, and love it. It's my favorite thing to do. Even if I don't need rain, I try to collect it. Got some lightning too. It's the only part I don't like. Lightning. You know, because I've got a lightning rod attached to my home. haven't been struck yet. Have some friends that have been struck big time. So yeah, let's get some rain. Let's do it. Just like that, free water. It is coming down. Woohoo! Ooh, I need to close this. It's coming in the wrong way. Ah! All right, well, we better fix this. The storm has subsided. Let's see how we did. What did I say, like 10-ish gallons? 6 to 10 gallons? So, there's my two jugs. Jugs. this one's full. That one's almost about 3/4 full. So let's call it 7.5-8 gallons almost. And that came from, looks like it skirted a little south. There's my other 3 gallons that way. See a rainbow? We got a rainbow? Yeah, we sure do. That was pretty sweet. Man, I love catching rain. So much fun. So yeah, that looked like about a 10-gallon storm. I'm getting pretty good at guessing those. My record is, I think, around 17. That was a pretty good storm too. Just for a frame of reference with collecting rain, I've got 2 tanks aboard White Pearl. Each is about 30 gallons. One's 35, one's 30. So I carry 65 gallons. I go through approximately 30 to 35 gallons a month. So I can carry about 2 months worth of water on the boat before needing to refill back up. I've never dipped below 30 gallons since leaving, so that's pretty good. Boqueron right now. This is a little bit of a partyville spot. We're just gonna do one walk down the road here, check it on out. Boqueron, Puerto Rico. Ah! Hey, ¿listamos? ¿Cómo te llamas?
Lee.
Provincia. Provincia. Y mis amigos. Okay, here we are. And ¿qué es este?
Chichaino. Chichaino de coco.
Okay. Slow going this morning leaving from Boqueron, but now I'm starting to get past the wind shadow of the southwesternmost point of Puerto Rico, which is right there, Cabo Rojo. Cooking along at about 4.5 knots now. Today's mission is to get to a place called Margarita Reef. There's supposed to be some pretty sweet snorkeling to be had. I haven't been able to do any good snorkeling since about the Bahamas. So I am stoked. Hopefully we will get some cool underwater shots. Couple of hours sail from Boqueron. Once we tack here, we will officially be going east again. So I've been going south along the west coast. Now we're gonna be going dead east. Got some amigos. It's been a while since I've seen you. Oh, come back. Come back. Come on. Scared my amigos off. Making very slow progress. This is brutal. Getting around this point has been difficult. Quite calm. See the reef out there. And it's about to go from 40 feet to 6. Like that. Here we are, Margarita Reef. See the breaking waves there? It's the edge of the reef. Pretty deep on the other side. I don't know if I can get to it because of the shallowness over there. But this reef stretches maybe a good mile, way down there, all the way, pretty far down that way. White pearl sitting proud in the distance. I'm hoping I can find any kind of sea life. If I get lucky, maybe some sharks or something, but we'll take anything. came in here okay last night. I could see stuff. There are coral heads everywhere. It is 9 feet deep right now. That coral head could be 5 feet up. I don't know. Oh God, 8 feet. I really need someone up on the bow right now to be spotting this stuff. I came out snorkeling and looked at all these and I was like, are you insane coming in here by yourself with no one to spot any of this? I think the worst might be over. I'm back on my route coming in, but look at that, 9 feet coral head. I can see them on my downside scan, bottom scan. Look at that one. This is awful. Get me out of here. I'm in a minefield. This is terrible. Ten feet. Another one right over there. Feet. I think we might be good. Going one knot. This is the wrong time of the day to be doing this as well. Should be doing this with your light over your shoulder. You can see them. Light coming this way, right? But here is why I'm doing this right now. I was gonna wait until tomorrow to do this in the morning, but there is a tropical storm threatening to become a hurricane. Some of the spaghetti model has it coming right over where we're at. So I need to go scope out a little hurricane hiding hole, which I've got in mind. I don't know if I can get into it. It's just over yonder. If I cannot get into it, I'm gonna have to go back to Boqueron and give up all my progress yesterday. A little off course here. So at any rate, we are headed to look for hurricane hiding holes. This particular spot is a phosphorescent bay at night, if you get lucky, right? Known for having phosphorescence. So we're gonna check that out, see if I can duck in there and hide out for the next couple of days, maybe get some video work done or something. That was scary. That was not good. How not to do this? I mean, even anchoring out here was a little bit crazy. Of course, I didn't say I wasn't crazy. Shouts to Mr. Hammerhead, who hooked me up with this swag cap. It is a skate company. Stay Tropical, Tropical Wind, Tropical Wave, something like that. It's a skate surf company. I guess they really do a great job with sponsoring people and everything and kind of getting them started. He gave this hat to me in Dominican Republic. Was stoked about the story, told him I'd put it on, wear it from time to time. Shout to you, buddy. Looking like a true beach bum now. Got gnarly out here real quick. Storm to port, reefs all over. decent sized waves. This right next to me. Was just trying to get off that reef, man. Just on the outside, the edge of that. Though it might be coming this way, I don't know. I think it's headed more west, but definitely got some of that. This is pretty foolish to be out here right now. Well, that was fun. It's got a nice little rainstorm there. One of those cells did hit me. Phosphorescent Bay is dead ahead. Looks pretty nice and protected in there, except from dead south. Looks like it'd be a great spot for ducking out a little tropical storm hurricane there. Pretty cool scenery on this south shore, Puerto Rico, I must say. Quite nice. Storm develops into anything.